Hi there, Carl again, another episode of NodeGraph TV, and with me today I have no one else but the big almighty Rob Wunderlich. Welcome.
Thank you, Carl. Happy to be here.
We're so pleased to have you here, and this episode is going to be about something that concerns every one of us: data quality and testing. So hopefully we will have a couple of interesting minutes here just discussing that.
Those are two subjects dear to my heart.
Perfect, Rob. So before we dig into this, let's start talking about data quality. And if we look at this slide, this actually says that 66% of CEOs in the US doesn't trust the data they are analyzing. And also an even greater number, almost 80%, have concern about the quality of the data. What do you, if we look at them, what does this mean for you in terms of just looking into these facts, and are they recognizable?
Yeah, I think it's a common concern. So the CEO understands their business, they understand the measures that they want around that business that are meaningful, but they're not really clear where the data came from. Mm-hmm. And in many cases, the person who produces the data is many layers away from the CEO. The CEO doesn't know them, doesn't have a relationship with them, doesn't have confidence. Could have even been an external consultancy. So it's, I think, it's an understandable concern for sure.
Just to keep addressing this, I mean, if my thought and my belief is, if there are a concern about something, you need to do something about that. And what do you believe would be a first natural step to recover this challenge, internally or externally?
Well, I'm happy to be here to talk about NodeGraph, because I think NodeGraph is an ideal solution to implement a data quality solution that everybody can agree and trust. Yeah. So I think NodeGraph in particular, there could be other solutions as well, but NodeGraph is what I'm familiar with, can give that confidence to everybody in that information chain.
Great. Sounds promising. It sounds like we at NodeGraph, we have something, we really need to dig into this and really need to, I mean, take lead for this and the entire data quality track. Exciting. Just to also to mention, I mean, data quality can mean so many things. So if I just ask you, Rob, what does data quality mean for you?
So it means that the data accurately reflects, because the data is just numbers, but that's a reflection of the physical reality of the business, whether that's bank balances, shop floor, number of people working. So it's complete, it's accurate, it's current and contemporary. So, you know, it really just has to have meaning. So the meaningfulness and the correctness of it is what comes to mind.
Sounds good, Rob, and I couldn't agree more. If we look at, I mean, we said that we are going to do this about data quality and also testing of data, but since we have spoken a little bit about what data quality is and the potential gaps in there, I mean, if we talk at testing, what is testing? And if we adapt this in the entire environment of data, what are your thoughts about what this is test?
Well, data quality is the goal, and testing is how you get there. Testing is the tool that takes you to that goal.
And also, if we just elaborate a little bit more, I mean, since there are so many ways of doing these types of tests, because data can be tested in so many ways, just to talk a little bit about more things about what different types of tests is available at the moment, and what perhaps would you see for the future in terms of testing?
So that's an excellent question. Testing is a very broad topic. Testing in data, testing in information technology is a big field that involves a lot of things. So we're talking about testing your Qlik solution and the data delivered from that. Yeah. Talking about some very specific kinds of tests. One is a regression testing, meaning that is the data still, is it correct? Does it return the correct results? So once we validated the initial installation of the dashboard or the solution, we want to know on an ongoing basis, is it still correct on a daily basis or every time it reloads? Secondly, is the currency of the data, is it being refreshed on a regular basis? And is that refresh delivering results in terms of, is it complete? Does it include everything, and is it still accurate? So those are the two major kinds of testing. There's also, sometimes people use the Qlik scalability tools, which are excellent tools. They use them for load testing. They can also do regression testing. And load testing is testing your environment to see how many users you can get on there. It's not really a data quality type of test. It's a you know, it's a capacity test for planning.
Yeah, and I mean, since there are different types of testing data as well, what would you say be the greatest benefits of having a test-driven approach in terms of coding data and also deliver data to the organization?
I can think of two significant benefits of a test-driven approach. One is confidence. It closes that gap between the CEO and the person who produced the data and validated it. So we got a common tool that everybody agrees on. And the second one that a lot of people don't quite realize, but is scalability. You can scale up. You can produce more work with the same amount of people with confidence. And you're not spending time running around trying to correct things or check. You have confidence and you can scale up.
And also to, I mean, to see it have, if you have a methodology on testing and perhaps you have a platform or a tool or a solution to do that, I mean, thoughts about having it, because if it is a software that is running the testing, is it more, I mean, in terms and in times of data literacy and providing data for everyone, what I mean is that, is it better to have like a software conducting the testing, or is it better to have like an organization, a field that is doing it? What are your thoughts on a question like that?
That's a good question. I would say it's a combination of both. You need the human intelligence who understands the business and can do the initial validation. Where the software comes into play is recording what those decisions that those humans have made and be able to repeat those tests on an ongoing basis to be a proxy for those people. And that's again where the scalability and repeatability comes in. You can bring in additional people to the process. They don't necessarily have to be trained in the data. They know that these pieces that have been validated are being continuously validated by the software.
Fantastic, thanks for that, Rob. And also, I don't really know if it's a sensitive topic, but I think we can address this. Perhaps the audience would like to know a little bit more about this. But if you just take the question, I mean, there is a concern among CEOs about the quality of the data. They also have trust, they don't really trust the data they are analyzing. So why isn't a test-driven approach in common in the Qlik environment?
Another excellent question. It's primarily due to the complexity of implementing a software-driven test approach in Qlik. It was very difficult in QlikView, much easier and possible in Qlik Sense. And there are tools like NodeGraph that are doing a great job at that. I also think that the Qlik developers are generally reporting operations type of people who don't come from a testing background. People who write software for a living, for example, may have been exposed to various concepts and tools around testing, and it may be just part of their toolkit. But the development audience that creates Qlik has not necessarily been exposed to that.
Great stuff, Rob. I mean, this was just a short story about data quality and testing. And if you would like to learn more about testing and data quality, don't hesitate to go in on either Rob Wunderlich's blog or at NodeGraph's webpage. I mean, we have a lot of great content, a lot of great articles there. So please feel free to do that. And thank you very much, Rob, for attending this episode of NodeGraph TV.
My pleasure, Carl. Thank you.